We want to graph the feasible region given these four inequalities. The feasible region is the region in which the ordered pairs would satisfy all four of these inequalities. So what we'll do is graph and shade each of these inequalities and then find the region that is shaded four times. So to keep track of all this, we'll call this inequality 1, this inequality 2, this inequality 3, and this inequality 4. But let's start by taking a look at inequality 3 and 4. Inequality 3 is x is greater than or equal to 0, so the boundary line would be solid, and it would be the line x equals 0, which is actually the y-axis, or a vertical line passing through the x-axis at 0. So that would be here. And then because it says x is greater than or equal to 0, we would shade to the right, or this region here. For inequality 4, we have y is greater than or equal to 0. So the borderline would be y equals 0, and it would be solid. So we have a horizontal line passing through the y-axis at 0, which would actually be the x-axis, this line here. And it says y is greater than or equal to 0, so we would shade above the horizontal line, this region here. So notice how we're only concerned about the first quadrant, and in most application problems, this is the case, and this is normally when you'll hear the word feasible region. Now let's go back up to number 1. Because the inequality symbol is less than or equal to, we will have a solid borderline, and now we'll graph the line 3x plus 5y equals 45. For this, let's go ahead and make a t-table, or table of values, and determine the intercepts of this line because it is in standard form. So to determine the y-intercept, we'll set x equal to 0 and solve for y, and then to determine the x-intercept, we'll set y equal to 0 and solve for x. Notice if x is equal to 0, we would have 5y equals 45, divide both sides by 5, and we have y equals 9. And then when y is equal to 0, we would just have 3x equals 45, divide both sides by 3, and we have x equals 15. So let's go ahead and sketch this borderline. The y-intercept is 0, 9, so just below 10 here. And the x-intercept is 15, this point here. And then to determine whether we should shade above or below this line, let's go ahead and pick a test point. The origin is always a good point to test because the coordinates would be 0, 0. Notice if x is 0 and y is 0, we have 0 is less than or equal to 45, which is true. So we're going to shade below the black line. Notice right now this triangular region in here has been shaded 3 times. And now we have one more inequality to go. Looking at inequality 2, again we'd have a solid line because we have less than or equal to. So now we'll graph 6x plus y equals 36. Let's go ahead and make another t-table because it is in standard form. We'll set x equal to 0, solve for y, and then set y equal to 0 and solve for x. Notice if x is equal to 0, we would just have y equals 36. And then notice if y is equal to 0, we would just have 6x equals 36, divide both sides by 6, we have x equals 6. Let's go ahead and plot these two points. Again, the y-intercept is 36, here right above 35, and the x-intercept is positive 6 at this point here. So the blue line passes through these two points. Again, let's see if we should shade above or below the line. So we'll test the origin again with coordinates 0, 0. So we'd have 0 plus 0 is less than or equal to 36, which is true. And since the origin is below the blue line, we'll shade below. And this does get kind of messy, but hopefully you can tell the region that's been shaded 4 times is this small quadrilateral here that is bounded by the green vertical line, the orange horizontal line here, the blue line here, and the black line here. So the feasible region is this small region here. which means all the ordered pairs in this region would satisfy all four of these inequalities. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.